Good evening. I'm Colin Kingsley, once again sitting in for Alastair Cook, who always seems to be on vacation whenever we do these things. Anyway, tonight we introduce the schedule for the upcoming 2018 season of Broadway on the Brazos at the Granbury Theatre Company. Our first entry for the 2018 season is a Broadway production that has thrilled audiences around the world. This show is called... We've got a large air mass moving in from the northwest with high upper-level winds, meaning with this low-pressure system that's hovering right around this part of New England. Close to Connecticut, really near Rhode Island, maybe Massachusetts. very near Vermont, not quite New Hampshire, and well, almost Maine. Back to you, Bob.
Speaking of almost Maine... That's the name of the first show of the Broadway on the Brazos 2018 season, and will be performed live on stage at the Granbury Opera House January 26th through February 11th. This delightful romantic comedy will be a great way to bring us from winter to Valentine's Day.
Mi amor, linda.
Arturo, ¿cómo fue tu viaje?
Fue fantástico, aunque extraña tu rostro resplandeciente.
¿Cuándo regresaste?
Anteayer, siento no haber llamado. Yo estaba durmiendo todo el día.
¿Y este viaje fue por negocios?
Sí, tuve conocer un cliente en una pequeña ciudad de Texas.
¿Cuál era el nombre de esta pequeña ciudad de Texas?
Gilbert, Texas. Una ciudad linda. Pero me faltaba casa.
Arturo.
Sí, mi amor.
¿Recibiste un mensaje telefónico en tu trabajo ayer?
¿Y qué desea?
¿Dejaste las gafas en algún llamado? Chicken Ranch.
Gabriela, ¿por qué?
Me entré di que el rancho de Polo es una casa de prostitutas.
Gabriela, mi amor.
Espero que de Texas devoró tu dedo en tu casa de Texas.
Lo mejor.
It was a dark and stormy night, a night befitting the dark underbelly of the New York underworld, a world of gangsters and gamblers, and all sorts of unsavory characters.
Men like Sky Masterson, a gambler so depraved he thinks luck is his own personal lady. He'd gamble on nearly anything. And then there was the beautiful Sarah Brown of the Save a Soul mission. How a dame like that ended up with a guy like Sky is a story that only Broadway could do justice. There's also the dubious ringleader, Nathan Detroit, and his pack of cronies. Nicely Nicely, Rusty Charlie, Benny South Street. Those clowns, they're always rocking the boat. Nathan's so full of himself, he barely even sees how much his gambling lifestyle causes his dame Adelaide to lament. In my line of work, I have found that this world we live in is chock full of opposites. Up and down, black and white, night and day. Guys and girls.
Oh, hello there. I am Hardbody Hans. Come on down to Hans Automart, and Hans will let you drive the hard bargain. You see what I did there? Yeah? You can do it the hard way, or you can do it the hard body way. Looking for a deal you can't pass up? Put your hands on this hard body, huh? I'm only joking.
You know what this is? Hands on a hard body. Okay, so maybe you didn't get the joke because you've never heard of a hands on a hard body contest. Well, Hans will tell you. You and 9 other contestants put your hands on the hard body. The last one to touch the hard body wins the hard body. And also this bag of cash.
So come on down to Hans Automat, and you too can get your hands on a hard body.
Okay, when's lunch?
And brothers and sisters, today my sermon is focused on what God has to say about the sensual and salacious sinfulness of dance. Our young people are being led astray by the evils of rock and roll music and the temptation that the sensual beat causes. Parents, and those of you joining us at home through our international television ministry, you must protect your children from the evils of dance. And now, our dear brother will lead us in this morning's offertory hymn.
Welcome back. We are still on the hunt for the elusive wolf, known to many in the area for being extremely big and bad. I came across this old print, which I think may belong to the malicious creature. No, wait a minute. This print looks as if it was made by a slipper or shoe, huh? Well, let's follow the trail a ways, see what happens. Now, this creature has been causing the villagers an awful lot of trouble, blowing down houses. Wait a minute. What's this here? Looks like a piece of cloth, as red as blood. Huh. Looks as though it was torn off of some sort of poncho. Maybe a cape, more likely. Which is very interesting, because I found a very similar piece of cloth stuck in the mouth of a cow as white as milk this very morning. I think it may be time to continue my trek through the wooded area and see what happens. Wait, shh. I think I see something. Some sort of hairy beast through the thicket ahead. Follow me. It's gone. Oh, that was the strangest thing I ever saw. It looked like it had hair as yellow as a squash, or maybe corn. It fled through the brush that way. Now, I know that I shouldn't, but we are about to go deeper into the world. It's my leg.
This is a PSA from your TSA. Remember, whenever traveling, the following items are not permitted for carry-on. No firearms. No baseball bats. No meat cleavers. No cattle prods. No brass knuckles, nunchucks, or throwing stars. No fireworks. No dynamite. No hand grenades. And no baby formula. In quantities greater than 3.4 ounces or 100 milliliters, unless agent is notified prior to screening. If in doubt, remember our slogan, you can't take it with you. This slogan is a total ripoff of the title of a comedic play which premiered on Broadway in 1936, which has absolutely nothing to do with the challenges of modern-day air travel. Any similarity to this popular stage show is purely coincidental. You Can't Take It With You is a zany madcap comedy appearing on stage September 21st through October 7th.
In the not-too-distant future, next Sunday A.D., there was a guy named Joel, not too different than you or me. He did his job well with a cheerful face, but his bosses didn't like him, so they shot him into space.
On his head?
Well, someone's having a bad hair day. Boo. Come on, go burpee.
What's going on? What are you doing here?
Catch. Look at all those spices.
I hate you when you're drunk.
What's Robert Redford doing in this movie?
Get back there!
Read a book.
Stupid IKEA furniture.
My fruit punch! It's like an episode of Dynasty.
Oh, what?
Focus!
What? Hey, go get me some popcorn in the lobby.
Give my creation life!
You are not evil.
Wait, what's this now?
You are good!
This looks like a film worth watching.
I'm going to teach you, I'm going to show you how to walk, how to speak, how to move, how to think.
If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits?
Hey, give me one of those crackers. I got some cheese on it. Put it on the Ritz.
Welcome back. We hope you participated in our telethon supporting PBS and our ability to offer commercial-free programming like the one you are currently enjoying. What? Well, I know we interrupted our audience for 20 minutes or thereabouts to ask for money, but we need to somehow pay for your ridiculous union salary. Well, if it were me, I'd get rid of all that nonsense and bring back a more sensible pay structure. Getting off holidays for this and that. Not only do you want Thanksgiving Day off, but now you take off the whole week. And then there's Christmas. Christmas. The most wonderful time of the year. And it's right about then that we need a visit from Jacob Marley! To remind us what Christmas and life is really all about. And that's just what's in store for the Granbury Theatre Company as we round out our 2018 season with a stage adaptation of this holiday classic. We celebrate our 5th anniversary with the return of one of the most popular and enduring holiday shows of all time. Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol will be performed November 23rd through December 23rd. Secure your season tickets now and enjoy the deepest discounts available. You won't want to miss a single show. I'm Colin Kingsley, good night, and until next time, farewell.
And Ralph.
Of all the unprofessional, I know people, you know.
This is the conclusion of today's broadcast. Tune in tomorrow when we resume regularly scheduled programming.